Hello, I'm Warren. Today we are gonna learn a classical Chinese sentence. What is classical Chinese or literary Chinese? So-called 文言文 is a written form of old Chinese. It's based on Chinese classics from the Spring and Autumn period through to the Han Dynasty. Despite rapid change of the spoken language, Chinese people considered classical Chinese as formal writing. Consequently, the language situation of pre-modern China can be summarized in one word: coexistence of their contemporary colloquiality and the ancient language. Speaking in spoken Chinese, writing in classical Chinese. Further, just like Latin was an international language in medieval Europe countries such as England, Germany, etc., East Asian countries, including Korea, Japan, and Vietnam, had been documented their history in classical Chinese, because they didn't have their own writing system until early modern period. However, it doesn't mean these countries were the part of Chinese territory. They were just a part of East Asia cultural sphere. The basic rules of word order in classical Chinese. A. The subject precedes the predicate. B. A modifier precedes the word it modifies. C. The verb precedes its object. In conclusion, its basic word order would be topic, subject, verb, and object. Now let's start this. I assume you already have studied Mandarin Chinese. At the same time, I organized this lesson for the people who don't understand Chinese characters at all. So, you only need to know how to pronounce each characters, and that's all. The first lesson, 子曰, 学而不思则罔, 思而不学则殆. The master said, if one learns but not think, he will have gained nothing. If one thinks but not learn, he will be in danger.
孔子说, 只是学习却不思考, 就无所得, 只是思考, 却不学习, 就会危险.
The source of this sentence is the Analects of Confucius. He was a Chinese philosopher and politician of the Spring and Autumn period. His family name was Kong, and the given name was Qiu. This 子 mostly means child or baby. In this sentence, however, it means master or mentor. The master refers to Confucius in this context, because it's the Analects of Confucius. Actually, the English word Confucius itself was originated from Chinese 孔夫子, the master Kong. 曰 is to say, saying something. The subject would be the master Kong, and the verb is 曰, to say. Confucius said, why did I make it the past tense? Just because his speech was already happened. Confucius has already passed away, right? So the present or the future tense is impossible. Next, 学, to learn or learning. Its traditional form is like this. Then just learn? Who learns? There's no subject, right? So, when do we not express the subject in classical Chinese? A. When it is understood from the context. B. When it is indefinite. C. When it is impersonal, that is, when it is to be understood as the environment or the world in general. This sentence is the case B, indefinite subject. Come back here. One learns. Anyone, anybody who learns. Next, R is a conjunction, means but. One learns, but. 不 is a negative adverb, not. 思, to think or thought. One learns, but not think. 则, and its traditional version. This word is the particle introducing the main clause of a conditional sentence. So, it makes a conditional. If one learns but not think, then 枉, nothing, pointless or meaningless. He will have gained nothing. 思, one thinks, are, but. 不学, not learn. 则, if one thinks but not learn, then 带, which means dangerous. The master said, if one learns but not think, he will have gained nothing. If one thinks but not learn, he will be in danger. What does Confucius want to instruct in this saying? The harmony of education and consideration. What we learn is about social agreement, common sense, the principle of our space and universe, information about our planet, world, and countries, what's right thing to do and what's moral or ethical, etc. However, even if we have this knowledge, they could be useless and meaningless without our own opinions. When it comes to simply memorizing and storing information, AI, artificial intelligence, is much faster and much more precise. So, we have to consider, we have to think. The creativity is an instinct for survival in some aspects. Of course, just thinking without education is also dangerous. The danger of prejudice and dogma. Therefore, Confucius requested the harmony of learning and thinking about 2,000 years ago. 子曰,学而不思则罔,思而不学则殆。Thank you for watching.